fine, you may clap. Nate, why don't you go? Okay, that matters.
We're good?
Yep,
this one. This is Dylan. This is Nate. I'm Justin. And we're Eagle River Band. This is 64 Sessions. There's a place down in South Alabama where the muddy water flows through the stump-infested creeks and sloughs where hardly anybody ever goes. That's where them hogs run wild and them cypress trees grow big and tall. That's where I learned about living and all about life, and that place is called Warsaw. On the Tom Peak, takes my breath away. I still travel down every spring just to wet a line. I drop my boat off in the water, go sit and have a real good time. Dropping minnows off in a treetop, pulling a big old slab every time. That's the best feeling I've ever had, man, and that ain't no lie. On the Tom Peak, green water way, though that muddy water washes my blues away. On the Tom Peak, to that special place down in Warsaw, Alabama, where that muddy water flows through the mud. Tom Peak, we water way. Though that muddy water washes my blues away. Tom Peak, we water way. Though the beauty of that river, it takes my breath away.
Welcome back to the 64 Session Studio, and I've got a new band in town, and I'm excited to introduce you guys, the Eagle River Band. What up?
What's going on?
What's up? So what's this up, is guys? Justin, Nate, and Dylan. Dylan, you're an alumni. Yeah. Welcome back.
Yeah, thank you.
Stash in full glory.
That's it.
Trim her up this time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. Yeah, glad you guys could come in, dude. So, you guys do original music, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's what I thought. We're
going to lay some of it down tonight.
Dude, I'm pumped about it because I've heard good things, man.
Well, that's... I hope so.
Yeah, Mr. old Donnie Glenn. Donnie James.
Yeah, Donnie James.
He turned me on to you guys. He turned me on to you back in your old band. Right.
Oh, yeah. Cypress Creek.
Yeah, me and you had gotten together a while back about trying to get in here and get that popping, but you guys kind of had to split, go your own ways.
Yeah, business decisions, yeah. You know, typical mm-hmm. life choices, everybody having to do things. You know, obviously kids, family comes first for a lot of people, so.
Right. for most normal people.
Most normal people, yeah.
Right, yeah. So you guys are somewhat a new band.
I've already said that. We're a new band. We ain't really advertised ourselves a whole lot yet. We got a little bit of Facebook page going on, but me and Nate, you know, we've played for a long time. He was in Cypress Creek, he was a drummer, you know, we've been playing together for a while, so still a lot of the same stuff going on, just kind of name change. We brought Dylan on and
Playing bass, man.
Playing bass. He's out of his comfort zone. So.
Hey, stretch him out.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. He's bad as a bone.
He can hold it down.
I might just switch.
Yeah.
Just forever. Yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody gets
we all could.
Yeah. So how long you been playing music, Justin?
Well, it's kind of always been there as far as playing music.
Mm-hmm.
Seriously, probably about the last 10 years, like right out of high school. I graduated in 2010. So I guess that's when I really picked it up full time. My dad played a little bit here and there. So there's always been a guitar in the corner, I guess you could say.
Right. Yeah.
And grew up, you know, always loving it. My grandfather, he played a little bit. He's got a guitar stashed back. I got some older cousins, you know, they play. And it's just something that I gravitated towards.
Yeah. Man, I got some cousins that play too, man. And that was like when I was younger, not so much these days, but when I was younger, my uncles and some of my cousins, they like that was a focal point in a family get together. Was
definitely
when, like it got started when the guitars came out.
Definitely, you know? We still do it every Christmas, man. Yeah. My dad's side of the family, you know, he's got three or four first cousins. They all play.
They're
like uncles to me.
Right.
You know, we always go down family get togethers on the river and we just playing music, having a good time.
Yeah, man, that's so fun, dude. And some of the people, you know, my uncles and stuff, they're getting a little older though. It's like, we got just a few younger guys. I suck at guitar.
I'm
following along too,
with the best of them.
I'm horrible at drums. I can't do it.
Yeah.
It's impossible for me. It amazes me what y'all do.
Dude, it's hard.
It is.
You gotta move four limbs at the same time.
I'm good at this.
I can't even tap.
I can kind of do this, but when I throw the foot in there, it's
game over.
It's over.
Dude, that took me the longest to learn. I remember like when I was like 10, 11, and started kind of playing in church some a little bit,
mm-hmm.
I would just leave the kick drum out completely. I'd play like, and then, dude, one day I had this epiphany. It just dawned on me, like, because I would always try to play the kick drum on the same time I hit the snare. Like, that was my problem. And then it just dawned on me, hey, play it any other time besides when you're hitting the snare drum. And it kind of worked.
So, yeah.
And I was like, from then on, I started playing the kick drum, you know.
Yeah,
didn't you find your own sound with it?
It's
all about trying to find your own sound.
Right. Well, Nate, what about you, man? When did you start playing drums?
About 12 years ago. I played sports and didn't play drums till I was 20.
Oh, really?
20? Yeah.
Yeah. Did you guys go to school together?
We've known each other since kids.
His younger sister graduated a year below me, but we've lived right down the street from each other our entire lives. We always was in cahoots, riding four wheelers, raising a lot of cane, you know,
getting into trouble.
And,
cool.
Yeah. You know, and so Dylan, I've been playing with Dylan for on and off for what, 5-6 years now?
Yeah.
It's been a while.
Yeah.
We get together. We've done some acoustic shows together. We ain't know. We just getting started.
Y'all are younger than me. Well, so you guys didn't. So y'all didn't like put a terrible band together when you were kids, then, huh? Because you guys didn't really start playing later.
Well, me, Justin, and Cam started playing. I was learning drums and playing with Cam for a couple years, and Justin come. We all just kind of got the neighborhood band jam going.
Yeah, the garage band.
Yeah, the garage band.
They're up there. He had a pond, and I'd go down there fishing, and I'd hear him and Cam up there playing Metallica or whatever.
I couldn't play
or sing. I could just play a little bit, and I went up there one day, and it just that was kind of when it kind of took off a little bit.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I've been traveling up and down this awesome road. It gets real hard sometimes. I keep carrying this heavy load. I just keep on trucking. Yeah, stick to what I know. Cause it don't matter.
Did you always sing though? Did you
know? Yeah, I grew up in the church. Church of Christ, so we're not using instruments.
That's right. There's and, music, but no
yeah,
instruments.
Yeah, well, we all sing a cappella, so I mean, you know, if you're not singing, your mother's sitting there pinching you. It's like, hey, you better open your mouth.
Yeah.
But yeah, I've been singing since I was a little kid. Something I've always just, my parents love music. Just kind of graduated down to me.
Right. So. Are you one of those lead singers that sings harmony or doesn't?
If I got somebody to sing harmony with, I will. Like when me and Donnie go do shows, I'll sing harmony.
Okay,
for
cool, man. Yeah.
Yeah, I try and get it in as much as possible.
Heck yeah. Oh, yeah, I love singing harmony, man. But you know, some lead singers that are great lead singers, they just can't sing harmony.
I can't sing a lick of harmony.
Right, yeah.
At all.
It's hard. It's hard.
Point proof.
Nate, he's started singing harmonies recently.
Oh, right on.
Just over like the past year or so, and he's picked up pretty good. He might belt something out tonight. You just never can tell.
Maybe. Like it,
yeah. How difficult was it? Because I know it was tough. That's another element to add to drumming.
That's tough, playing drums and singing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Especially them stretched out notes. It ain't on the one or two.
Yeah. Yeah. And then, like, you got to position your finagle your mic stand a certain way. And I've seen, I've got
so you want to hit it with your hands.
Right, yeah, because it'll get in the way.
I told him to go headset style.
Dude, Garth Brooks style. Yeah, Garth
Brooks. You buy me a crown, I'll wear it. Myself. You buy me a crown, I'll wear it.
Dude, I thought about it. I need to invest in one of those, like, they come up and they gooseneck to the top. You know?
That's kind of how we rig his.
Yeah.
Bring it up. And we actually use a condenser mic, so.
Oh, okay.
He can actually pick up his voice.
It's actually been working better.
And the sound is really good.
It's kind of like an overhead.
Mm-hmm. It gives a good harmonic sound to it.
That's not a bad idea. How many shows have you guys played?
What?
As Eagle River Band?
As Eagle River Band, we played, we had Cam playing with us and another buddy of mine that grew up with us, Daniel Ingram.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, we got together. He moved back from Texas. Been trying to get something together with him. He played in a lot of really good bands.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
You know, been all over the music scene. Moved back from Texas, and he come and, you know, we started it with him originally. And we done one show at Twisted Barley and, you know, tragically passed away.
Yeah,
a couple days or next day afterwards, so. But we're just kind of picking on, keeping it going, and he wouldn't want us to slow down. He's wanting us to keep on trucking and keep on rocking. So that's what we're going to do.
Yeah. I had the privilege of talking with Dan, like, right when he moved back into town. I had hit him up because he was in Looksee, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I know Rob's from Jasper. Are all those guys from Jasper?
Most of them.
John from Cordova.
John, they came. I'm not sure if he's from Cordova. Because Carly, John's sister, she graduated with me, but they moved here at a young age. But they're based, they're from Cordova.
Right.
In my eyes, they're
close
they're from,
enough.
Yeah, they're here, you know, they've always.
But I had hit up Looksee, like, when I first got started.
Yeah.
I was like, hey, we'd love to have you. And he wrote me back and was like, actually, we're kind of split up. Rob lives in Prague.
Yeah, he moved way.
Yeah, dude, he got way the heck out of here. The family's doing really well.
Yeah, they're all good.
But he was like, you know, kind of split up. He said, but I'm going to be back home soon. And then sure enough, man, when he came home, he hit me up and we talked and I had him on the schedule to come solo. And we rescheduled one time. And then the next time I talked to him, I think he was out at Twisted that night. And he mm-hmm. was like, I had him scheduled for the next day. He was like, hey, can we move it to in the afternoon or in the mm-hmm. evening? I was like, sure. And the man, that was the last time I had.
I actually think John and John, the old drummer for Luke, him and Rob, I think they're doing something right now. They're about to release an album, Scout Team.
Sweet.
Scout Team. Check them out.
Cool.
I follow John on Instagram. We've talked a little bit, not much.
But yeah.
I follow his work, man. He's a very creative guy.
Awesome, man.
So he's keeping it going, too, man.
Cool. Good mm-hmm. to hear that.
Keeping it going.
Good to hear that. Yeah.
Fell into trap. Now they're gone away from you and me. You can't ever bring them back. They never had no second chances like me. I don't feel like I'm worthy of the love and the grace and the mercy that was shown on me. I know there's one out there that could use it, oh, more than me. Someone in a struggle, don't be afraid to reach out. You might be saving your own brother. We never know what this life has up ahead. It might be you someday that needs someone to hold out their hand and give you a second.
To original music, do you write all the songs in the band, or how does that go about?
Well, we just kind of got into the writing not long ago. We got into it a little bit with Cypress Creek, and then we wrote a couple. We actually had one on YouTube. It's called "I Ain't Got Jack." Y'all check it out if you want to. Yeah. It was kind of that's kind of like the only real recording that we ever did. We did it kind of in the garage, it out there,
kinda and then did it yourself.
Did it ourselves, and. It's really all we got out there right now, but it was going pretty good there for a little bit. But we wrote a few songs there, but it's like we've always kind of been a jam band, we'll come in there and try and get creative and say we come up with a riff or a lick or he's got a beat and then I work off something like that. We'll get a song structured, and we'll come in every time we jam or practice or whatever you want to call it, and we'll work it out, and then. I think we could put some words to this.
Yeah.
So we'll get together, try and spit some words, some ideas about kind of where we want to go with a song. It's not just me, by no means.
Right.
Dylan, he's kind of come in late to the game. He's not really been in on the writing session yet.
Not yet,
but it's going to. He's got some ideas floating around. I know he does.
Oh, I know he does.
He's got some original songs, too. He just don't like to tell nobody.
They're so sad.
Hey, I mean, would you consider it the blues?
Oh, good point.
Well, the only cure for the blues is to listen to the blues.
Yeah.
You know?
You heard the man.
That's it. It's got to be good blues there.
Yeah. That's exactly how, you know, one of the first bands I was ever in, a first original band, with some of my buddies, Rob and Dustin, like, that's exactly how we would do it. We would just jam until we found something we played something where they were like, hey, that's cool.
Yeah.
You know? And then we'd build off that, mm-hmm. and then we'd go back later and try to put lyrics to it.
Yeah, you got
to
have that creative process. Yeah, man. You can't just, I don't think you can come in, or not me anyway, I can't come in and say, all right, I'm going to write a song about this. Here's and here's the lick.
Right.
Here's the progression. It's like, no, we're just going to come in here and act a fool real fast. See what we can come up with.
Right, yeah. That's more fun that way, too.
Yeah.
So you guys have a Facebook, you said?
Yeah, Eagle River Band. We got an Instagram, too. So
you do?
Yeah, we're on Instagram, Facebook. It's in the process of getting revamped right now.
Man, dude, I tried. You know, pretty recently just started the 64 Sessions Instagram page. And I'm like, man, I'm starting with a fresh slate. I get to build it like I want to. I don't have to put it on my personal page and confuse folks. And then I put like three things on there.
I got tons of pictures from, you know, of shows that we've done. And there's only like the startup few pictures. And it's just like,
I know, dude, it's a lot of work.
We got somebody helping us out on that end though right now. So. It's going to take a lot of pressure.
Is that a secret or
it's
what?
It's a secret.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Secret.
Well, don't tell nobody.
Yeah. We don't want to release all the information. We want to remain a little secretive.
I got you. That's probably a good call. Don't reveal
your can't
call.
Reveal it all. Yeah. Open an eye, you know.
Yeah. I know, man. I need some help. Like, I would love to have an assistant or something to help me run this.
Yeah.
Just with booking people. Because, man, like, when you're trying to, like, you know, we had to reschedule like twice.
Oh, this has been the cahoots for 8 months. Talking back and forth about
man.
What's going on, you know?
And like, I knew if I didn't communicate with you every other day or something, like, all right, let's shoot for this.
Yeah.
If I put you on the back burner and somebody else will be like, hey, and I'll forget about you, or, you know, for.
Well, I think that is what happened, because I kind of put myself on the back burner for a little while.
And you're not the only one, bro.
Yeah, I mean, but I remember when you first started this, I was like, it's really cool what you're doing, though.
Thank you. Man.
Super stoked about it.
That's sweet.
But I've been following them since day one, but he said he's going to do one a week. And I know some people that do some stuff like this. I'm like, that's going to be a tough deal right there.
I did it for a while.
Yeah.
I slacked off lately.
But I mean, you deserve it.
Hey, I don't know about all that.
Once every 2 or 3 weeks, dude, it's fine.
The good news, the good part about, you know, you being later to the game is I've got it dialed in a little bit more. You know?
Yeah.
Like, I go back and watch some of the first ones now, and it's like, oh, why did I,
do it that
cringy.
Way?
Yeah, I'm like, but... That's the aim of the game.
That's why you got to be with anything, right? Man, you don't ever want to do it. Just
can't be sitting still.
I mean, you got to try and do it better the next time.
That's right, man. If you guys want to keep up with Eagle River Band, go check out their Facebook page. And if you made it this far in the video, thank you so much for watching. If you do me a favor, hit the thumbs up button. Drop us a comment. Tell us what you like and what you didn't like. And thanks so much for watching, guys. And I'll see you not next week, but when I see you. Okay.
Adios.
Bye. Full trip. Said I
a good beat.